And so we had a little basil plant. And the end of the year, brought it in, I just put it on the windowsill in the kitchen. And I thought, I'm just going to leave it there and see what happens. And so I left it all over the winter. And it's grown. I haven't told them to water it. I haven't told them to do anything. I've just left it there. I've never seen it watered, but it is being watered. And it was like this horrible little basil like bush with like one little crooked leaf on it. And now like it's a massive thing. They're all like lovely, caring people. And it shows like I don't have to push them. I don't have to say, do this. This is why it's good for you. I think it's like a role reversal. It's like they're being cared for and they're caring for something. My name's Jacob Kelly. I'm very proud to be an unregistered practitioner. Like, we're the workers, we're the ones that are spending so much time with the patients, and we love it. It's the greatest job out there for interacting with people. You're nursing people that are severely unwell, and you can work with them through that and see them through that end goal.
When I was working in the elderly, I found, for me personally, I found it very difficult watching people die, and it's a real honour to help somebody towards the end in a dignified manner. I'm Joe Kelly and I'm a healthcare assistant.
But I remember when he started and then my middle brother started, I was like, nah, I'm never doing that, no way. And then I sort of grew up a bit and I was like, well, maybe I'll give it a go. And then I was hooked then, I started in elderly, which Joe worked in. It's hard graft, you know. You're nursing people, they say you don't get attached, but you do. You're nursing people and it's like nursing 20 of your grandmas.
I kind of followed into the job because my mum had suggested it, and that my younger brother, the middle one, Samuel, saw me go into the job, and Jacob followed, and I think it was just a natural progression for us. I really enjoy having one-to-one time with the clients. I think the further on up you go, the less interpersonal it gets. I really enjoy being able to help people out, and I think once you kind of get out of being an unregistered practitioner, you get further away from the service users. And I think I'd really miss it, I think.
You know, because you're unregistered, because you haven't gone to university, you have to show why you're worthy of that position. For me, it's always been different because I've never wanted to train.
A lot of the time it can be a lot about de-escalation and trying to keep a cap on a situation. It's part of the job that I feel that I'm particularly good at. There was a situation once when it turned into a bit of a standoff, and I kind of walked over to the guy and said, hello mate, do you want a cup of tea? He said, yeah, I'd love one, and walked straight into the ward. I think a lot of the time situations like can build up, but with using the right kind of techniques and just treating people like a person and how you'd want to be treated yourself, that situation was calmed down very quickly.
I like teaching really good life skills, which you are therapeutic and you will use when you leave. Things like just growing your own vegetables and stuff like that. Some patients were really shy, so it's just trying to get them out of that comfort zone, interact with others. Every ward I've worked on has won like awards for their garden projects. So we've entered stuff into local gardening shows and we've won awards for them. So I never thought like that would be my thing. You know, I've worked with people that have been really ill, and then just planting seeds have worked amazingly. I see too many jobs that are, it doesn't need to be a registered member of staff. And they go, it's only for registered staff, where they're not giving out meds, they're not doing any therapies, they're not doing any one-to-one stuff, and they're just for registered staff, where actually I said, well, that would be perfect for unregistered.
A lot of the time I feel like I'm left frustrated on the sideline. It's difficult because, you know, a lot of the time unregistered practitioners aren't invited to kind of the MDTs, whereas we spend the majority of time with that client. I'm proud of what I do. I'm really proud of when I tell people and they ask what I do. I'm always kind of proud of working within the NHS. And I think for me, more than anything else, it's treating people how I'd want to be treated myself. I've always looked at it as how would I want my mum or my dad or my friends or my brothers to be looked after. And that's kind of been what's kind of kept me going within the NHS.
Be a role model. That's the one thing I love where I am here. You get the best, like, feel-good moments ever. I've never, like, some of the, like, the nice things that I've had, I will hold with me all my life.
Yeah, it can be really frustrating, but it's kind of equally frustrating and rewarding.
It's a great career for working with loads of different people, getting to learn, you know, loads of different skills. As an unregistered practitioner, like, there are good opportunities out there. There needs to be more. The way things have changed over the last 4 years, way different. When I started, there wasn't opportunities, and now it's changing. And I feel now, with hard work, I can get the opportunities where I think I deserve. But yeah, it's wicked. I love it.